Exactly 1 month after a train derailment, the entire Scarborough RT has been permanently shut down. The decision comes 1 day after transit riders held a mock funeral for the TTC's beleaguered Line 3. Service has been offline since a train derailed just outside Ellesmere Station on July 24th. The aging system was originally set to be decommissioned in November, but that process has now been sped up as part of an ongoing review. Shuttle bus service has been boosted in recent weeks, and work continues to establish bus-only lanes on some of Scarborough's busiest streets. The use of express ground routes will continue until the Scarborough subway extension is finished. That will take until at least 2030.
This was a very important piece of Scarborough's history. I was there at the RT funeral last night, organized by TTC riders, and you could definitely sense that in the atmosphere that this is a watershed moment for Scarborough to have the RT shutting down.
TTC Chair and Scarborough Councillor Jamal Meyer says the plan is to have the full shuttle bus system in place before kids head back to school next month. Those who rely on transit say there's a lot of work to be done in a short period of time.
No one is surprised that the RT is closing. It's at the end of its life. But what is surprising is that solutions have not been funded and implemented yet. We need to see red bus-only lanes on the road, transit signal priority at traffic lights for the 70 shuttle buses per hour that are needed to replace the RT.
Talking about having dedicated bus lanes, how good is that going to work? You're talking about doing it on Kennedy Road in Midland, which means you're going to put regular traffic down to one lane. These things should have been planned a long time ago.
Them taking it away leaves another gap in Scarborough. You know what I mean? Like, what do we do now?
Mayor Olivia Chow has promised to turn the existing RT corridor into a dedicated busway at a cost of $60 million. At this point, neither the provincial or the federal governments have committed to helping pay for that project.